Good evening, good evening. My name is Tana Walker, and I am the director of this evening's performance of Robin Hood. Thank you so very, very much for coming tonight and supporting the theater program at Willamette. We could not do this without you. Saturday night's it's an extra special night to come, as it is our final night, and the production of Robin Hood actually marks the 20th show that I have directed here at Willamette. So. Thank you. And I couldn't have spent it with a better cast. These kids have, like all my casts, and they work so, so hard, and they are just the best kids, as you know, because they're your kids, they're your sons and daughters and friends and siblings and grandchildren and nieces and nephews, and the endless connections that you have to these students is what drives the performance. So thank you again so much for being here and for sharing your children with me for the last 2 months. It's really been my pleasure to work with them. I hope you enjoy the show. Thank you.
Sherwood or death.
But I'm just trying to confuse them, Robin. They'll think we're traveling minstrels, and when they all gather in a circle to hear my sweet song, zoom! Off go the arrows. On come the plates of venison.
Well, I can't deny it. It's a wonderful idea. And to make it better, what say we spread out some chairs and cushions? A table full of fruit? Set up a ticket stand.
You're making fun of me. You're making fun of me, aren't you? I come up with the ideas and you make fun of me?
And it's an amazing, amazing plan, Will. Assuming that the king's deer are as stupid as he is.
I see what you mean. Not likely.
Nope.
Oh, soup King John. You know, Richard the Lionheart hadn't died.
I know, bloody inconsiderate, wasn't it?
Absolutely, absolutely.
You know, oh, come on, Will. Not an empty stomach. Look what it does to you.
Well, find me some venison then, if you're so bothered.
I think I'll do just that. Who is she? Do you know her?
Just another poor Saxon girl looking for breakfast.
Aye, but she's different though. I think I'd like to meet her.
Oh no, not the rescue.
The rescue. I should appear in the best possible light, don't you think?
Aha! A beautiful maiden! And she's alone. What luck! Satan must be smiling today. How fortunate for me. How unfortunate for you. You will rue the day you met with the Baron Humperdinckles.
And what if I don't feel like ruing?
Yeah!
What are you doing?
Yeah! Well, I'll tell you what I'm doing if you so want to know so much. Now will I, the Baron Dinkelberg, pluck me forth a fresh flower of Saxon maidenhead. Hood, say your prayers, for who will save you now?
Go ahead and try. I'm waiting.
You're waiting? Waiting for what?
Go ahead and pluck if you're going to pluck.
Yeah, but you really should resist.
Hold, O thou, Norman piglet! Ravish not this fair maiden. For I have 3 feet of cold steel shall make a sieve of thee.
Go ahead and let him come. It's fine.
Oh, no, it's no trouble.
Saxon dog, who art thou that thou wouldst cross me in battle so?
Vile chicken-headed thing, my name shalt be thy last knowledge in life, for I am who men call Robin Hood.
Gah!
Yes, cringe and pray to it. Deity watches over the swine of Norman knighthood, if any. Take that and that, thou loathsome hound of hell!
Oh, I am slain!
It is done.
I live no longer!
It is finished!
I die!
The dead, yes! He'll trouble you no more. Fair Saxon maid.
He didn't trouble me at all. He didn't even touch me. All he did was yell a lot.
Yes, frightening. And once again, I'm forced to take a life. Yes, a depraved, wretched, meaningless Norman life, but a life nonetheless.
There's no blood on your sword.
What?
There's no blood on your sword. It's clean.
Well, typical Norman, wouldn't you know? Blood thinner than water.
I think I've had just about enough entertainment for one day. Thank you, good Riding Hood.
Robin.
Yes, Riding Robin. Good day.
I can hardly let you go unescorted. I didn't save that pretty neck for it to be slit once you enter the wood.
Oh, I was so looking forward to that. Now, how am I to have my pretty neck slit if you keep tagging after me? Or my eyes put out.
Lovely eyes.
Or my head.
A magnificent head.
It should be. It's the head of a Norman. A wretched, depraved, meaningless Norman, which is what I happen to be. Hold right there!
Well, well, well. I don't know which one of you did it, but you're both gonna have to come with me. Sheriff at the side.
Now see here, I'm not going anywhere. Do you know who I am? I'm Marion Harford, chief lady-in-waiting to Her Majesty Queen Eleanor herself.
Pardon us, maid Marion, we didn't see you there.
You'll be so happy to know we brought Queen Eleanor along with us. Say hello, Eleanor.
Oh, why hello.
And I'm the lovely Helen of Troy. We should get together for tea sometime.
Why, wait. Let's go now. Come along.
I'm warning you. You're making a dangerous mistake.
I arrest you in the name of the Lord High Sheriff of Nottinghamshire and another young man who is one.
You now trespass.
Look, 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 look. This has gone on far enough. Will, get up. The joke's over, Will. Look, it was just a joke, Will! Show the royal forces that you're not dead and they won't kill us, all right? Look, this is insane. That's my friend, Will Gamwell. We are hunting deer when...
Oh. That was bright. Hunting the king's deer, are we? Well, guess we won't take you in after all.
You won't?
No. We'll hang you right here.
Deer.
I have special permission to hunt the king's deer. You, my lady, have special permission to scratch wings and fly away.
I see how it is. We're supposed to go hungry, is that it? Well, if I can't fill my belly, I might as well fill yours instead. Well, who's it going to be, my fat little friend? Who's going to be first?
Who is going to be first?
None of us is who, you twit! We all are together!
About time you rejoined the living, Will.
Don't even try it, bucko.
Sorry, Robin. I had to sleep off a hangover.
Well, how do you feel now?
Rested and ready to go.
Good! Time to carve up the king's fat, juicy venison.
Ah!
Do you see that?
Ah!
a wicked reputation.
Well, I'm sure her ladyship must have heard that in the court sometime.
That's my advice. Take it or leave it, Saxon.
And what about you? You weren't exactly dancing with your man.
Fortunately for me, they didn't believe I am who I said I am. In which case, the only name they have is yours, Will Gamwell.
Why doesn't it look right? Here I have King John coming to the most important part of the castle, the place where I receive, entertain, transact, destroy. Just doesn't look right to me, no matter what I do. Maybe it's too austere, some more tapestries, but I don't want it to look cluttered. It's something out of place, I just can't put my finger on it.
You are much too worrisome, my lord sheriff. I do swear, I can see raw nerve endings jutting from your temples like tiny pennants waving in the wind. I have seen this before. Your face will turn bright plum, the tendons bunching up like a pack of dogs wrestling for meat, while the veins in your throat start rippling like some loathsome congregation of worms. In Hereford, we have a saying, the only thing hotter than the heat is the fire.
And from whom did you glean that pearl of wisdom, my lord?
Well, of course, that's not actually a saying, in that no one actually said that, although I'm sure I heard it somewhere. In fact, I might have even said it myself. But the point I'm trying to make here is things could always, always be worse. Therefore, we must remain calm, like me, through all manners of storms, floods, volcanic interruptions, and visits from King John. All of which come under the heading of great forces of nature. Do not shrink from greatness, but rise up to meet it.
What is wrong with this room?
Grasp it by the royal antlers, so to speak, look him squarely in the eye and proclaim—
It is you! It is you that is wrong with this room! Oh, that's it, that's it! I'm content now.
You see? There they go, those horrible veins.
Shut up, Hereford! Finally, I found the source of this disorder.
Like throbbing blue caterpillars.
Everything else in you is quite pleasing. The decor is positively scrupulous, but you, you're always there spewing words like nauseous gas, like some sort of lazy lunatic grandmother.
Oh, and now the blood's boiling. Swelling your head into like an overripe melon, it can do not but explode. Then you'll really have to worry about the appearance of the room, unless King John is taken with the idea of the sheriff's brains as decorative regalia. A thought I find as amusing as it is revolting.
And put that fruit down, serving that great mouth one after another. Not now, Hilton. Stuff the fruit.
My liege.
Your Majesty.
Rise, my lord sheriff. Rise to wealth, to fame, to your own barony. But first rise to patience. Rise to tolerance and understanding. It is therein that greatness lies. Can we defeat an enemy we don't understand? I think not. No more than we can gain the respect and loyalty of valuable friends through hostile bullying and infantile rages. If you plant fear in people, you only fuel their instinct for self-preservation, and believe you me, there's no disease more dangerous among the servile. They're so impressionable. Soldiers, cooks, bookkeepers, pieces of clay waiting for the right hands. But they must be sensitive hands, the art becomes malformed. Given proper care, however, they will gladly die for you. With complete trust in their master, he need but bid them into the hideous jaws of death. and they will march proudly and unflagging to their doom and to their respective hereafters.
If your majesty thinks for a moment I'm going to mollycoddle the monkeys and buffoons I'm supplied with, then he is sadly mistaken. I find it hard enough not bludgeoning my lord bishop, never mind the bloody cook.
You will be quite civil to my lord bishop. Hertfordshire is an important part of my power. Now I understand that a complete transformation of one's innate temperament doesn't happen overnight. You have 1 week. Now, to more important things.
And are there any?
Oh dear, well we certainly know there are far more serious matters. For the instance, in the area of tax collection. We seem to be meeting a little resistance here, are we not?
Why, there's not a county in the realm.
No, we're not meeting a little resistance. We're meeting a lot of resistance.
Since the last increase, tax collection has been the greatest expenditure in the kingdom.
You're telling me that? You've barely broken even.
I'm telling you because you don't seem to be aware of the cost and difficulty involved.
Nottinghamshire is breaking records in tax resistance, is it not?
I haven't charted the rest of the kingdom. I have more important things to do.
Nothing. Nothing is more important to me than income. 4 years ago, when my brother the Lionhearted had the good sense to die, he also had the good sense to place the crown on my head. Unfortunately, he neglected to give me the majesty that goes along with it. I look in the mirror and do I see a king? No. At least not while my mother lives. Queen Eleanor has not only more power and glamour, but she also holds sway over the barons. Without money and without the support of the barons, I cannot execute my fondest dream, the invasion of my former ally, Philip of France. Only then will the true King of England stare back at me from the mirror. My mother, we'll deal with later. The taxes we'll deal with now, my lord sheriff.
We have much more than our fair share of laggards and troublemakers.
Oh, I don't know. They seem to be everywhere, like insects. I swear, I can hardly ride the streets without being forced to gaze upon disagreeable faces. And me, a man of God, do they bow to me? No, there's all these raised heads. I think the only time they lower their heads is when they're sucking on a horse trough. In fact, my own horse shows me more reverence. I had a man whipped yesterday for cursing in my presence. Cursing! Mind you, he dropped something on his foot, an axe or something, and set forth with a litany of such foul vulgarity.
Hereford.
That it was enough to make even my lord sheriff blush, I do say.
Bishop!
I'm sure you have your rabble too, Hereford. But nowhere do they thrive with such robust abandon as they do under my lord sheriff's nose.
I have just instituted harsher penalties.
Let me see your books.
I have just instituted these measures. Am I to magically transform the temperate entire kingdom along with my own? Perhaps a prize, a new horse if you pay your taxes on time. Maybe a tour of my Lord Bishop's castle. A good look at that bejeweled lump over there. That'll inspire them.
Talk he to me thus, and yet he lives. The man begs to be put to death. Here's my head, he says. But such is my patience, my understanding that here the man stands, knowing he trod close to the river of death and found the gentle bridge that I laid out for him. The rest of your life, Sheriff, shall be your lesson and my gifts.
Milton.
Aye, good, my lord.
fetch the books. I've just given the royal foresters permission to perform on-the-spot executions, provided I get their heads.
Keep the heads, take the heads, make them into bloody flower pots if you like. I want their money.
My lord, Rickon Hazel is here to see.
Not now, Hilton.
That's all right. It'll give me a chance to peruse them.
My lord.
Ah, my dear Rickon.
Are you feeling all right, my lord?
Of course I'm all right. What's your business?
It's not good. One of the foresters is dead.
Dead? How?
Well, there were these two men, a woman, see, and they're playing this game, and one of them was really dead, and...
What?
Well, they're hunting the king's deer, and we tried to arrest them, but they got away, and one of the foresters died from his wounds.
Who are they? I want names.
One of them was called Will Gamwell. He's the one who cheated on him, the woman. She was a real corker. She tried to tell us she was Marion Harper, lady-in-waiting to Queen Eleanor.
Queen Eleanor, how could you let these... never mind. Send a pending warrant for Will Gamwell and find out who the others are.
I'm told this Will Gamwell frequents Blue Boar Inn at Lincoln.
Blue Boar Inn, that strikes a bell. Yes, Blue Boar, extremely obstinate in their collections. Perhaps a visit to Lincoln is in order.
Make me a wealthy man, and I'll make you a baron.
You there, good fellow. Why don't you let me cross before you mount the bridge?
Good lad.
No.
Look what you did. You see, that's not exactly what I had in mind. You see, if you start your great bolt across, I'd have to sit here and play witness to your lumbering progress. Now, ordinarily, I'd be only too happy to sit here and take a nap as you waddle along. But as it so happens, I'm headed to the Blue Boar Inn, hoping to meet a certain lady there. And you know what they say about the lady in waiting? They don't. Yes, well, if you don't mind. A man of few words, I. Well, perhaps you're a man of action. If so, then don't. Go away.
You don't.
Come on, speak. Come on, speak. Are you dead too? Is that it? You poor, poor brute. Well, today is your lucky day, for Robin Hood has taken pity on you. Right now, I am digging deep into my pocket to come up with tuppence.
Ooh.
Tuppence. Come on. Go get the coin. Go get it. Go fetch the coin, you bloody stupido.
I'm not deaf. I'm not dumb. I won't go. And I spit on your tuppence.
Oh. I see. Oh, thou mighty oak. I meant to say. Well, this is a problem, isn't it? You don't back off this bridge, Is that a yes or is that a no?
I'd much rather you step aside, little man, than more than a sport for one day.
Little man, how about some archery?
What are you doing? Shoot with your bow and arrow?
Well, yes, I suppose I'll have to.
Well, isn't that right sport of you? Shoot a man with a bow and arrow who's unwieldy with a quarterstaff.
A what? Oh, you mean your stick? Is that what that is?
Yes. Feel it with your head.
I'm all right, thank you.
No, really. I insist.
Well, if you insist, I suppose I can't just shoot you, my poor animal friend. Let it not be said, Robin Hood is not a fair man. Wait here a moment.
How you hold it. More like it if you must know.
Heading to the Blue Boar?
Hi, how about that? Why don't you join us, friend? I'll buy you an ale.
No man buys an ale for John Little Mansfield. What's funny, Mansfield?
No, Little. My name is Robin Hood, and this is my friend. Will Gamwell.
Scarlet. Will Scarlet's the name.
Well, I must admit, all this unnecessary gabbing has worked me up quite a thirst.
Well, good. Let's off then. So as I was saying, this beautiful lady.
Song, our little brilliantly danced, you have
feet like ancient crabs.
Drinking much, you're starting to make sense. Then maybe you've had too much, Agnes.
Well, I haven't. She's had a tooth in my head for sale, you shin bones, you cat guts, you onion eaters.
He's a prince of me.
Compared to you, madam, I'm the king of cows.
That's the way, but Ellen, I'll play you a tune.
Oh no, we'll be married in a week. We can wait for that tune.
No, wait. Yes? No, that's not what I meant.
Father warned me about you traveling minstrels.
Well, I won't be traveling for much longer.
Why can't you get a real job, like a miller or a tanner?
Ellen, why, just a moment ago, a fellow was telling me that minstrels will be worth a fortune around here. Lyrics dropping like gold from their lips.
Fellow? What fellow?
Good little fellow. Right there. He calls himself, Lord Croup.
Alan, that's much the miller. He means well, but he's given to...
Great imagination.
Yes.
Well, that's what you need, Alan. Imagination. That's what gets you places. For instance, now the barons are all raising their rent, right? That means more money for entertainment, right? Mm-hmm. And who do they hire for that entertainment? Minstrels.
Mm. Well, who is it that pays the rent in the first place?
Oh, that's okay. With the extra work, we'll be able to pay the increased rent.
Catherine. Catherine, love. Fetch me some bread, will ya? Let me do that, and you pump the ale.
I wouldn't like that nearly as much.
Three ales, Pete.
I'm thirsty. Make it four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Sold. I can see. You won fair and square.
What did I win?
I don't know.
I must confess, this fellow has a loose bowstring.
Sir, I'm not an archer and I never professed to be one. I'm much the miller.
Funny, you didn't look like much to me.
Oh, sir, think you'd be the first to make jest upon my good name? Why, every bumpkin in Lincoln has done that. You are evidently a simple man, but I am not.
You have put me in my place, fair lady.
Tell me, how long has he been in the woods?
Too long. Can you point the way back?
Get away from me, poor mad fellow. Why, my horse makes more sense. Try you, mercy, it is my horse. I thought I left you tied up.
Call you me a horse, you?
Call you me again? Where did you get that?
Don't be upset just because you're a horse. It's all right.
Hey, no. No horse playing here.
Don't hurt him, little John. He has to serve the drinks.
All right, everyone.
Make way for the Lord High Sheriff of Nottinghamshire.
Pray tell, which of you loathsome rabbles even the innkeeper?
I meet him.
I hereby arrest you for non-payment of back taxes.
We try to keep up, but you
It's
keep
all right, me. Love. We'll settle this.
Nope,
I'll settle this. You're to be made an example of. Your inn is to be confiscated in the name of the crown and all proceeds collected thereof. And your punishment for evasion is death.
No!
You go alone, boy!
I have a quota to meet.
And I thought we had about a Mansfield.
Aye, the sheriff of Nottingham, huh? What do you think, Robin? Back to Locksley?
Who's that? Who's out there?
Victims of harsh injustice and cruel tyranny.
What?
The rabble.
Greetings. Find yourself some ground. It's the only thing that's intact these days.
I hear the sheriff's working on that.
Ellen?
Quiet out there, boy, unless you want the Fosters over for tea.
Who's there? Have you seen Ellen? Ellen Deerwald, anywhere?
I haven't seen her.
Sorry, boy.
Come on, help me look.
No, you keep on searching. The only thing that you're going to find is Royal Foresters. Just hope that she has enough sense to hide for the time being.
That's not what I'd expect of men of England. Lie down when there's work to be done.
Now you stop talking or I'll take out your jawbone.
If you do that, he'll never talk. Well, just what are we supposed to do then?
What is so dry your tears.
Tears? There's no tears left in bloody England.
Well, where does that leave us? I mean, we can't cry, and we can't run. We must have nothing left to lose. This, my lads and lasses, smells like the bottom of the barrel to me, which means we can only go up.
We'll go up all right, just like Edom. He went up just now.
No, we won't. Not before our time. Not before we stop the sheriff and his men.
Are you mad? Oppose the sheriff? That's what Edom did.
I'm one man, but we're not one. We're many, and if we keep on gathering more, standing together, working together, there's not a power in all of England that can stop us.
Foolish, Robin. By far the most foolhardy idea I've ever heard. When do we start?
Now, that's just the kind of talk I'm talking about.
That's all it is so far. Talk. You want to back up your talk with force?
Aye. But this time, not with a quarterstaff.
I'm in.
Calm me in, mate. What do we got to lose?
Let's up an anchor and let's set sail.
Well, if you're all going to do this.
That's the spirit. What's your name, Squire?
Agnes the Bland. I'm the tanner.
Good. We'll get you the sheriff's hide. You?
Mike Skateboard.
Alan Adair.
I'm Much.
We know. We know.
Will Scarlet, Little John.
That's Little John.
And my name is Robin Hood.
Well, Robin Hood, you seem to be the one making all the decisions. So where are we holding up?
She's right. Foresters will snatch us any town they see us in.
Then we won't go to a town. We'll use the forest right here at Greenwood Glen. We'll know every inch of it. And we'll strike quick, like hawks, and then disappear into the brush.
I like this strike, Robin. I do, I really do. But what does it mean?
It means we hurt the sheriff in his most sensitive area.
Not...
Yes! His pocketbook.
Oh. What? Like thieves?
Oh, far from that. In fact, we'll be balancing the books for him. We'll be distributing King John's wealth back to the poor people it came from.
Kind of roundabout, ain't it?
That's right. We're going to complete the circle. First, we must enlist. A handful can't do it. Anyone you can trust, bring them back here. We meet at this tree.
That one, they call that the Sherwood King.
The Sherwood King it is. Are you with me?
Ah!
Then I christen the lot of you, men and women of Greenwood.
Ah! Ah!
In your garden. How do you do it, especially at your age?
Weed.
I beg your pardon.
It's not so much a question of growing flowers as it is destroying weeds. The one negates the other.
I see. I didn't know any better. I'd swear we were talking about something other than gardening.
Nonsense, John. It's all just weeding. Every now and then you get one tough little bugger who refuses to come up.
Very well. I'll play. Whatever do you do then, Mother dear?
There's only one thing to do. Grab him by the balls and yank!
I see. I think these gardening lessons are over. How quickly I tire of games.
Oh, you think these to be games? I have cards in my sleeve I haven't even thought of using yet. You better quit while you're ahead.
I've allowed the barons yet another tax increase. You know, I'm beginning to think they're liking me more and more each day.
You can give them free cows and shine their pottery for them, and the loyalty they have for me will only grow stronger. Something you don't understand, John.
No, I don't understand it. Lionheart's dead. You're about to be.
My, what sentiment. Don't count on it, John.
See here, Mother, what good can it possibly do you to resist my invasion of France?
Another bloody war so you can fill your coffer? Over my deceased corpse.
Very well. I'm not going to kill you, Mother. The barons would never forgive me. I have something more terribly subtle in mind. Something in the nature of a deal.
You have nothing to trade, Johnny.
Haven't I? What about the life of Marion Harper? She's your favorite lady in waiting. Some might even say a friend. Is she not? It seems she was involved in the murder of a royal forester without hunting. That fiery temperament of hers. I wonder where she gets that. Of course, the Sheriff of Nottingham laughed at the idea it was really her. Didn't have the heart to tell him that Marion's favorite hobby is hunting buck, and that she's given to lowly dreams. dress and buckskins. Convenient for hunting in the wood. Hardly what I'd call a typical lady in waiting. Would you, my dear? Of course, he could still find out. I'll be holding a meeting of the barons in 2 weeks. There should be plenty enough time for you to send out a series of messages. Oh, what a good king am I, and wouldn't it be a marvelous idea to invade France? That sort of thing. Start arriving soon if I were you, Mum. Dear Mum, before all that reading starts to cramp your hands.
Have some more mutton, my good man! Don't mind if I do. Can I interest you in some Momsy? Momsy? Why, I thought you'd never ask. Thank you. And bread, perhaps? How about some bread?
Oh. Yeah. That hits the spot. Thank you. My bonny fellow.
Can I interest you in some more Momsy?
No, I couldn't.
I insist.
All right, if you have another bite of mutton.
Why, thank you.
Don't mention it.
What? Who said that?
Down here, Friar. Just thought the two of you would like some company.
My jesting is nothing to jest about. How dare you, behind my back.
Well, it is a rather ample back, Friar. Enough for two of you, I wager, and talking to yourself like that. I make it at least 4 of you.
Why are you scurrying, Flynn?
All right, Friar. All right, Father. Henceforth, I shall never laugh at your sport. It's nothing to joke about. It's true. Why, I'd even say they're downright sad.
Yes.
Children weeping in the streets. Women tearing their hair out.
And don't you forget it. You're sporting again. Well, you little...
Again, Friar, I meant no harm. I've been bitter ever since I lost the use of my legs.
Huh. Sorry, fellow, I didn't know.
Don't pity me, Father. I loathe pity.
I'm sure you're used to it. What's your business here?
Alas, none, but to leave this terrifying wood. But crawling thus, my progress is quite slow.
I can well imagine, my worm-like friend. Is there anything I can do to be of service?
Oh, would you? Oh, I would be ever so grateful. Would you, dare I say it, carry me through the wood?
I'm sure it's little effort.
You're sure? All that food won't explode or anything, will it?
Food won't explode. I'm well contained.
Well packed, yes. Like a winter storehouse for a family of 700, I wager.
Well, better hop on my back now.
The expanse I perceive as great and wide as the great Ottoman Empire itself.
You flatter me, sir. You do.
Oh, not at all. Your girth has no justice. Nothing in the known world I can compare it to, except the known world. Oh, why have we stopped? We've barely progressed. The woods are still thick around us. How they seek to surround you is one of the mysteries of nature. Oh, that doesn't sound too good at all. Surely I've winded you. No small task, judging the amount of wind you could hold in you.
Perhaps you could hold yours till we reach the wood's edge.
I don't mind. Never at a loss for words. That's me. You know, the way you are with food.
Bless my soul, a gold sovereign.
Where?
Right here, you capital twerp.
ready for a trap to my woodland wits?
Rather give you one, my gluttonous friar. Whoa. Not bad, your worship. Learn all this in the monastery.
No, from caring sinners like you.
Spoken like a man of God.
More solid than you expected, eh, Ragamuffin?
The best of all. Hold on, Friar, hold on. I don't want to hurt you anymore.
I don't want to hurt you anymore either. Looks like I've come to the right place, if this is the camp of Robin Hood.
It's the camp, and I'm the man.
I should have known.
Welcome to Sherwood, Friar.
Tuck. Tuck's the name. Tuck, tuck. Tuck it away.
Well, I've come to join your band if you have room enough for a man of the cloth.
There's room for the cloth. Don't know about the man.
If there's room enough for Galligantua here, I'm sure there's room enough for me.
Don't worry, Friar. We can always make the paths wider.
Easy. I'll just grab you by the ankles and use you as a plow.
You just try it.
You lost.
I know.
Yes, well, let's show the good friar how we work. What have you got, Alan?
The lord and lady were kind enough to part with some silver bracelets.
Ooh, they shouldn't have. What about you, Meg?
A wealthy merchant insisted we have his gold chain.
Oh, how thoughtful.
Agnes?
A little old innkeeper got tired of carrying around this heavy bag of coins.
You helped a stranger? Makes me proud to be a leader. Little John?
A couple of jeweled abbots asked if I'd like to make a contribution. Said no, would you?
Well said for my benefit, sir.
What about you, Will?
A couple of gold stars.
And much?
Little.
It's all right, he's trying. Carry on, Mitch. You'll bring back something sooner or later.
Later would be my guess.
Good Master Robin, perhaps if I stole from one of us, you know? Take from the poor to give to the poor?
Much, it kind of defeats the purpose, don't you think?
I suppose. I guess I'll have to look elsewhere, to the Orient, perhaps, or the land of Prester John.
Robin, the Prioress of Kirkley's.
Greetings, good cousin.
And to you, good cousin.
That's Robin's cousin.
I gathered.
How was your journey here?
Without incident, I'm glad to say. They tell me there are bandits in these woods. I'm inclined to disagree. At least they've never bothered me.
Well, I'm relieved to hear that, Prioress. Meg, some food and wine from our cousin.
Oh, I can't stay long, Robin. My duties are most time-consuming, especially in these trying times. Lately, I've had to cut back, even at the Priory, and that pains me deeply. Helping the poor is all I have in the world. Why, if it weren't for you?
We do our best, cousin.
Yes, you always did, even when we were children. And you do remember how terribly poor we were then.
Like it was yesterday.
No, well, I do still feel poor in a way. Scraping to get by, avoiding new taxes, playing political games with the barons on one hand and the bishop on the other. How I long for simpler times.
We all do, but it's never simple, is it? No matter what we change, we always long for the better, I suppose.
I best be on my way. People are waiting.
And they won't be disappointed. Alan?
Much thanks as always. I noticed you have a holy man in your midst, Robin. I'm very pleased to see that. Good day.
Fare you well, cousin.
Robin, what does she do with the booty?
She buys ale and makes merry.
She distributes to the poor part of what we take.
Aye.
Right, I know the sheriff's very nose too. Stranger's coming, break camp.
All right, Meredith, don't leave a trace. Let's go.
Now, I'm not saying that you murdered a royal forester, my dear, but the fact that you were there can implicate you.
But you talk as if I know this Robin Hood or something. Really, we only met once, and that under the most unfavorable of circumstances. Why, I don't even like him. Neither would you, believe me. He's brash, arrogant, rude, and unscrupulous.
Don't leave out the horns and tail.
He tried to make my acquaintance under the most absurd ruse.
He must have been desperate to meet you.
Desperate is a word. Ridiculous is even better.
You saw through it?
A side of beef could have seen through it. Although, I'm sure the village maiden is absolutely thrilled by that sort of show.
Well, I hear he's making quite the reputation for himself. I understand the sheriff is particularly displeased.
Perhaps, but it's nothing to do with me.
I wish that were so. But the fact now stands that if I don't comply with King John's wishes, he will have you arrested and put to death.
I'm so sorry, Your Majesty. I've put you in grave difficulty.
It wasn't your doing.
Let me take to hiding, to the woods even. I can survive. Don't let him hold my life over your head.
Marion, I don't know.
It's the only way. Why, we're deep in Sherwood now. I'll just stay here.
Really, dear, are you sure that's absolutely safe?
Look, just me and Mother Nature. I'll hunt and fish. There's not a soul around for miles.
Good afternoon, good gentlewoman. We mean no harm.
But since you are of class, just to cut above the rest, we'd have to rid you of some of your possessions, as it were.
Spread it around,
so to speak.
If you please. Don't worry, ladies. If you're lucky, you'll become poor. Then we'll give you all sorts of things.
No. There's no reason for that, good lady. No reason at all. You have my word, no harm will come to you.
You're not going to hurt us?
Not at all.
Your word?
My word.
Good. Let's go.
Wait, now hold on there a minute.
Why? What's the point? You've given us your word. You're not going to harm us. What's stopping us? What's keeping us here, if not fear of harm?
Alan's the smartest. Alan, go do something.
What can I do? Gave his word.
Now, why? You go and do that, little John. Give your word.
I don't know. I wasn't thinking. But I really wasn't going to harm them. So don't any of you think that for a minute.
Stop reassuring them. You're making it worse.
We're losing our credibility as outlaws.
How you people got by this far is beyond me.
Now don't you start, Briar, I've had enough of you.
Well, somebody better start. Now listen, ladies, if you don't give us your possessions, we'll be forced to surround you in a big clump, and then you'll never leave the woods.
You do that by yourself.
Fine, fine, you do that, and I'll be forced to hack my way through with 3 feet of well-tempered steel.
Wait a minute, Miss Ellen, wait a minute. That hardly seems fair. Promise not to hurt you.
Yes, you did, didn't you? But I didn't.
Robin!
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 Welcome to Sherwood, ladies.
There he is.
Oh, it's you. I was hoping to run into you again.
Your lucky day.
Ah, same attitude. That's what I love about you. Everyone,
may I present
Marion Harper, lady-in-waiting to Queen Eleanor.
Oh.
And bless my soul, this must be Queen Eleanor herself.
Oh, Your Majesty.
Well, he seems perceptive enough.
He doesn't believe you, Your Majesty.
Well, who would? A queen wandering out here, I can hardly blame him.
What a wonderful spirit of fun you both have. Come, you must join us. Refreshment for everyone.
Thank you, but we really should be going.
Oh, let's stay. I'm interested to see the life of an outlaw. Tell me, do you really give your spoils to the poor?
All but what little we need for our own survival.
Mere pennies, I'm sure. How humble of you.
You could stand a little of that yourself, my lady. Look around you. Do you see any of the riches, the fineries?
They're hidden from our eyes, I'm sure.
Yes, stubborn little. Would you like some wine?
No, thank you.
Oh, it's quite good.
Please, Your Majesty, let's go.
You don't give up, do you? I do love a woman who enjoys a good jest. What is it you really do?
Are you a tanner? A tinker's wife? An embroiderer?
Court executioner.
What's the matter, Will?
Nothing. I've just never seen her outside of London before.
Who?
Queen Eleanor. I saw her once in London. I really did.
Get down! Your Majesty, we could not, I mean, we would not.
Off with their heads! Sorry.
Please rise, you outlaws. I never understood the sudden attention everyone pays to the ground.
Your Majesty, our humblest of pardons.
It's all right, I'm sure you don't get many queens through here.
Quite a few, actually, about 4 a day, plus a few kings.
Your Majesty, even though I'm new to this merry band, please let me show you around.
Oh, I'm interested to see a bandit's lair.
Oh, well, for that, you probably want me.
Shoot for me, lamppost!
We just got here.
Yet I've learned so much!
Tell me, outlaw, does that bow serve a purpose, or is it just decoration?
Oh, it serves a purpose, miss. Quite a few, in fact.
That would suggest the user had some skill.
It does. It does. Are you familiar with this skill?
A sight more than you'll ever be, squire. Unfortunately, I've neglected to bring my bow.
Oh, miss, you're in luck there. We just happen to have a few extras lying around the camp.
Very well, Master Hood. If only to put you in your place, I owe you a drubbing.
Madam, I accept with all my heart.
Your disposition doesn't seem to be improving. If it makes a difference, I've spoken to your parents and they've given us permission to wed.
No, they haven't.
Well, I don't need their permission anyways. I'm the sheriff.
Upholder of the law.
Well, what do you want me to do, woo you?
Please don't do that. Please spare me a wooing.
Frankly, I wouldn't know how to.
Frankly, I'm not surprised. And I appreciate that, by the way.
My, but you do.
Don't touch me.
You do have a sharp tongue for a little ragamuffin whom I've had the generosity of dragging up from the mire.
You have me deeper in it!
See? You see what you've made me do? Oh, this had better improve, that's all I can say. When we're married, my dear, your attitude had better change, or I really will visit your parents, and it won't be so much asking for your hands as it'll be taking theirs. Hilton, take her.
Bishop, my lord.
Rain in heaven.
They're more important things.
Oh, I know. Robin Hood struck again.
Robin Hood, all I hear is Robin Hood.
Well, he's becoming more famous than King John.
Rob from the rich so he can give to the poor? What kind of nonsense is that? Does he know I'm just gonna take it away again? Hasn't he ever heard of taxes?
Idiots, if this absurd recycling of funds continues, I might as well burn the bloody books.
Sort of clever when you think about it. I mean, amusing little serfs. Seems like they're always up to something.
I'm glad you can take this so lightly. Have you forgotten taxes go to your church too?
Of course not. I never forget money, I just don't worry about it. See, that's the difference between you and me. You agonize and bang your head. I'll continue to spout pleasantry and good humor.
And in doing so, provide him the valuable ally you're supposed to be.
There they go again, those horrid veins.
Bishop!
Now, it just so happens that I've given the matter some thought, and if you calm down, well, I just might tell you about it.
Grace me with your brilliance.
Gladly. Now, it seems to me that if we deprive the dragon of its head, it will cease to breathe fire and smoke. Now, I have always said, to catch a thief, it takes a thief.
Have you?
It just so happens that in my native Herefordshire, there is a bold and murderous outlaw of great renown, of equal notoriety to this Robin Hood. He has done me many a favor in the past. For the right price.
And what might that be?
£200 should attract his interest.
It better do more than attract his interest. I'd expect nothing less than Robin Hood's head on a pole.
I find this preoccupation with the human bonnet disgusting, to say the least. I shan't be here for the delivery, I promise you.
Tell this brigand we'll pay him half now and the other half upon completion of the task.
Well, I'm sure he'll be agreeable. You'll find him a strange sort of fellow. As feared by the people of my region as Robin is loved by his. He wears the hide of a horse, and he believes it gives him power.
He can wear daisies in a dunce cap for all I care, as long as he gets the job done. What's his name?
Guy. Guy of Gisborne.
Sir, she cried, I've lost my spotted cow. No longer weep, no longer mourn. Your cow's not lost, my dear. I saw her down in yonder grove. You're no cow. Identify yourself, animal, if you're a member of that family as I perceive you are. A wolf? A bear, perhaps. Though that I do not hope. You're no fish. Unless fish has fur and rabbits swim the sea.
Hello, little fellow. Say, did I scare you? I didn't mean to do that.
You can talk?
Talk? Well, of course I can talk. Can't you?
I was worried. I thought you might be a bear or something.
A bear? Imagine her talking.
I'm
a horse!
You are a horse. I'm certainly relieved at that.
Aye. So am I.
You know what? Wait till my friends see you. I don't usually bring stuff back to camp, but now.
Friends? Camp? Well, what can this mean, little neighbor?
I'm not supposed to talk about that. Unless you're all right. Do you think you're all right?
Oh, I'm better. Then, all right, I am looking for the camp of Robin Hood. Have you heard tales of him, little man.
Mayhaps I have, in one form or another.
Aye, lad, in many such forms, he takes ivory tale. This Robin is a wild one with skin on bark. One day, in a gold spinning hag glance, while his merry band fly through the forest on wings of silk, and live in the ground, in mighty caves, drinking blood by the light of the moon.
This horse has some strange notions.
Oh, methinks not, little. What's your name?
Much.
Much. Why, I would fain have to see it for myself. Do not believe the tales I've heard. These aren't just horses' tales. You get it? Horses' tales? Tails! Tails! Tails!
Tails!
Exactly.
I don't know.
What's to know, little man? Now, let's have a swig of satisfaction. A merry old time, and talk of Robin.
I suppose this is how you wait for unsuspecting maidens.
Well, I don't always shoot them with bow and arrow, but yes, this is the general approach.
And he's proud of it. Truly unbelievable.
Well, I don't always use the rescue, of course.
The rescue? You mean you have a name for it, like it's some form of a dumb show?
Well, it is. It's entertaining, isn't it?
Well, it is dumb.
Yes. Here now. If it's so dumb, how is it that my lady-in-waiting happened to fall for it?
Fall for it? I did nothing of the sort, and I am not your lady-in-waiting.
Thank God for small blessings.
I saw through your childish ploy right from the start.
You ate it up like mutton.
Oh, really? What an imagination. Not to mention an insufferable ego to match that of King John.
Here now, watch that tongue.
Why? Will you put an arrow through me?
I'd much rather put one through that deer, but you scared him off.
What? What deer? I didn't see him.
He's gone a mile now. Scared the antlers off him.
Scared the antlers off you, more like.
No. Wasn't the antlers. Listen, now we got a real one.
Really? How gullible do you take me for, Sir Knave?
Anyway, you'd like me to, my lady.
Oh, you call this a road? This is not a road! Oh, God, I look more like the bottom of a river or something. Can't you clear this stuff out of my way? These branches and twigs, like the infernal tendrils of hell, reaching up to drag me down and deprive the gentle earth of this abundance of holiness.
I thought you wanted a shortcut.
No. What I wanted was for you to fix the wheel of our coach.
Well, I couldn't carry it by myself now, could I, your grace? Or if you would let me back to the task.
When my back? Oh, how disarmingly funny you are for a forester. You're only trying to cheer me up. I haven't lent my back to anything since climbing on a swing as a child. Well, actually, I was helped up.
Are you sure this is the right way to the sheriff's castle?
I'm a lord.
It's most inconvenient. Why can't he visit Hereford once in a while?
I'm sure I can imagine, my lord.
Yes, I'm sure you can't. God, I'm certain my death is imminent. Even now I can feel its cold, icy hand upon my brow. Come with me. Come with me, it's saying. I might as well walk with my own head in my hands and offer it to the highest bidder.
Your grace should do his best to keep his lid on.
Oh, very funny. Stop trying to cheer me up. It won't work. You do better to kill me with your sword before somebody else does.
Is that an order, your grace?
Of course it's not an order, you ninny!
Good thing she didn't carry it out then.
Good thing for your sake, if you understood what a figure of speech is. Well, I suppose you wouldn't be a forester then, would you?
No, I wouldn't. I'd be a bishop.
Shut up. Shut up and let me die free of levity. Once the soil gently drums the lid of my coffin, you may jest all you want.
Thank you, my lord.
Oh, are you sure this is the right way? Oh, I can't stand this! Know that I shall die of heart attack long before the bandits find me. Well, that's a consolation at least. Promise me you won't let them desecrate my person.
Yes, of course, my lord. I'll find 100 of them. Come along.
Sorry, my lord. Didn't mean to startle you.
A minion of Beelzebub!
Hey, you. What's your business here?
Business? Oh, I know. Pies.
What?
Any fine pies today.
No, we don't have any pies. What would a bishop be doing with pies?
No. I have the pie seed. Pies? Who will buy my fine pies? You can use the pie.
Get out of the way. We don't want your fine pies. Where do you keep them anyway? In your pockets? Let's go.
What seems to be the trouble here?
We're trying to pass, but this pie salesman won't let us.
Oh, no, not the pie man again. He's always doing this.
Really? It's annoying.
It certainly is. Now you see here, that's a full-fledged bishop, and you're blocking his path.
Pies? We'll buy my fine pies today.
No. Break this up. What's going on here?
Well, the pie man's annoying everyone because, well, we won't buy his pies.
That doesn't seem right at all, does it?
Well, instead of talking, why don't you help me move it?
Needn't be cheeky about it.
You didn't mean it. Would you help?
We're trying to pass. Do you mind?
Well, we all mind, but it won't do any good.
Pies? Who'll buy my fine pies today? Pies?
Perhaps if one of you bought one from him?
Hey, why don't you buy one? Looks like you've had to practice.
Did you hear what he just said to me?
I'm sorry, my grace. I haven't kept track.
Oh, not another one!
So there's noise at you, stub in the woods?
There's nobody left in the woods.
What goes on here?
I'm trying to move the pie man.
Who are you pushing? Don't push the pie man!
Kill the pie man!
Try lifting him, maybe we'll go under. Who are all these people?
Why the pie man and two who got between you?
I had no idea this forest was so busy.
Reason with the pie man. He'll understand that.
You know, they should make the road much wider at this spot. Look.
All I wish in life is to sell my fine pies.
What is this? It's too confusing. Wait. Are you all in this together? Is this some sort of trick to get me to buy a pie?
All right. I'll take one. Let me have the pie. Let me have all your pies.
If you run away really fast, I won't rip your ankles off.
Fair enough.
What are you doing? Careful! I'm very holy! Thank goodness. Oh, think of how good stout monk. Oh, I hope you are flesh and blood and not some trick of the wood sprites.
I'm real enough, fatty.
Thank God. Fatty? What man of God calls me fatty?
A true man of God. One not so
richly dressed. Thus I am closer to God. Who could be richer than that?
We can, after we help ourselves.
To what abbey do you belong, sir?
To the Abbey of Sherwood.
I know of no such abbey. Who is your abbot?
Friar Robin Hood.
Oh, 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 God! Oh, please, please, I'll pay you! I'll make you all rich!
You hear that, lads?
We can be rich, just like him.
Yes, yes!
Hundreds of bishops of Hereford marching down the street, our bellies jiggling in the wind.
I don't know, Robin. Doesn't sound too good.
Robin!
Oh, now think it over, lads and lasses. It would give us a chance to be cruel and merciless and have all the food we can eat, depriving those less fortunate through higher taxes.
Yes, I mean no.
You mean yes, because that's the way you think. You're selfish and greedy and ignorant. You give nothing to the people except your loathing. You're the least holy man I know, besides King John.
He is a personal friend of mine.
Oh, I know. I've considered that in your sentencing.
Sentencing?
Yes, but no. I'm leaving you to a higher judge.
I think I know who you mean.
Really? I'm surprised at that. He's forsaken you long ago, as you've forsaken him.
What are you going to do?
First, we're going to let you pray, if you remember how. Then we're going to hang you.
No, 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 you can't, you can't.
I tell you, you're making a dangerous mistake.
Mistake? No, I think we've got it right. Noose, neck, tree, drop. Yeah, I think that rather does it. Farewell, your grace. It's been most unpleasant.
3, 2, 1.
I've been taught by the best. Well, hello.
Yes, I saw what you just did. Harsh, but I suppose you had it coming.
What? Oh no, Prioress, you didn't actually think we'd hang him, did you?
Oh, of course not. I mean, your prank was a harsh prank to play.
Of course.
Ahem.
Oh, Marion Harper, let me present my cousin, the Prioress of Kirkley.
Charmed. Robin, if it's all right with you, I'll take my charity and leave. It was a rather trying journey.
Of course.
So, the loot really is distributed to the poor? What a thing to say. Why wouldn't it be?
Oh, this woman has just had her doubts. I'm sure you've convinced her, Prioress.
Oh, I suppose.
Step up inside.
And turn the wheel to the breakfast side.
You're on key!
I'm sorry, my horse. I never professed the seeing ability of a four-legged animal.
Well, who would? Tell me more of this Robin Hood. It must be a right merry camp to live in.
I fain think it is good, my horse.
Fain?
I fain think.
Fain, fain, fain. Why are you all fain? Strike that word from my sight and never thus utter again!
Fain?
Strike, I say! Read yourself of such frills and humbugry. No pretensions, no affectations. Strike!
Aye, my captain, strike I will.
Now, where much, where exactly is this happy camp?
Camp? What camp?
Why, the bandits' camp.
Bandits? What bandits?
Robin Hood! Robin Hood! You know, you're the rich! Take a poor! Where's the blood camp? The camp of Robin Hood! You know the one I mean?
I think. It's yonder about 2 miles. You follow the stream uplands. You come to Greenwood Glen. There's a stand of oak and beech. That's the camp.
Ah.
Good horse, art thou mad at me?
You? Mad at you, my good little friend. Of course not.
Oh.
I'm just anxious.
Oh, because in all my experience, I never did meet one that was mad.
Oh.
Aye, oh, even and pleasant tempered they are. Why, they're the gentlest animal in the world.
Aye, so I am.
No, you're not. You're mad as a hatter, and I fain wonder if I am too for telling you what I done told.
Now, Saturday's come. Sorry to say.
For Sunday's starvation day.
Our hobnail boots and our thin cuffs too.
They are not shined and they will not.
The hides of large animals, and oh, I swear, some of them still had the entrails left inside. So foul was their stench. Many of the bandits had eyes removed and teeth missing, with fingernails like long claws scraping on the ground. Oh, as they tortured me, they left like banshees and feasted upon live insects.
No small children.
Do you want to hear the tale of my exploits or not?
I wouldn't miss this for the world.
Good. One of them was a giant, an ogre who caused rock slides whenever he spoke.
Rock slides.
Yes, another was a false holy man, a monk from the caves of Satan himself, an immensely fat and disgusting person, I assure you.
Yes, I can almost see him.
What? Yes, well, after torturing me for hours, they finally decided to end their orgy of pleasure by hanging me. Oh, an act I was sure would bring me instant relief. But even this solace was not allowed me. Such was their state of poverty and disarray that the rope was quite old and ill of quality and it snapped clean away.
Perhaps the strain was too much.
Oh, it was a cheap rope.
And they didn't try again. Why?
It was obvious they had no more rope.
Perhaps a different method.
Great cavities in their skulls revealed that many of their brains had been removed by habit or accident. I could not tell.
Their brains had been removed. Yes, that's why they constantly outwit us. So the rope broke and you outran them. Is that it?
Worse, they... Such was the utter disregard for my person that they walked away, laughing!
Oh, you poor man.
Yes, it was awful, so cruel.
Herford, you overstuffed cushion. If they had wanted to kill you, they would have. Can't you see they're just trying to scare us, to show us they're not afraid of us?
I escaped through God's will.
God hasn't listened to you for decades.
I can see further conversation is futile. I have belated my adventure, and that is that. These monsters must be stopped at all costs, especially this loathsome Robin Hood.
What was he like?
Oh, I was not impressed. By his bearing, his manner of speech, oh, I was not impressed.
And what about this guy of his born? When do we hear from him?
Shortly, I expect. But like a cooking pot, he cannot be watched in hopes that he will boil.
Shut up.
My lord, Guy of Gisborne.
I think I hear the pot whistling now. Send him in. You may go. Not you, Gisborne. Are you sure about this?
He's eccentric.
Thank you. Thank you, your majesty. Most gracious.
I am not your majesty.
Then, whose majesty are you?
200 pounds. 200 pounds for a clown. For a court jester in a horse's costume.
Oh, majesty, your little words, they sting me.
Get this pathetic wretch out of my sight!
Wretch, jester, clown, no one talks to me like that. And this is not a costume. This is the hide of a horse, tan and cured, tough as armor, but lighter still, through which the strength of the horse has passed to me. I have slain 60 men, which Robin Hood will be one more. Any who doubt, oppose me now.
If you touch me again, your head will leave your shoulder so fast you'll watch it hit the ground. Once your task is complete, you'll never set foot in Nottingham again. Is that clear?
Clear. Clear. Clear and mostly clear, your majesty.
I am not your... What progress have you made?
Oh, that which is best have I made, sir. The camp of which location I have in my hands.
And where is this camp?
Oh, I think not. Have an armed force march in there and scatter the lot. 100 muddy the water. That one man shreds clearly. Besides, that wasn't the agreement. It's the hedge you'll be getting, and not a drawn map.
Very well.
200 now, and another 2 when I deliver.
You're holding me up. You're holding me up for more.
Now that I have the location, yes?
Which of you is Robin Hood? I can hardly tell.
Come, come, lordship. I understand what this man means to you both. I heard they robbed some fat bishop just the other day. Mighty God, you should have seen Hereford blubber and sweat when he commissioned me. What a sight.
I was only trying to pique his interest.
Take this deposition, my attendant.
Thank you. Bless you, your sweet, kind, gracious majesty. Lord of all of the earth and that which is more. Sovereign of the realm of darkness.
That's the last time I let you buy horses for me.
Oh yes, I see your jest.
Are there any pending warrants for Guy of Gisborne?
Well, I usually just tear them up. The Sheriff of Hereford is a friend of mine, and believe me, warrants for Gisborne come as frequently as rain. More so, in fact, now that I think of it, and having been a rather dry season this year, at least in Hereford...
Hold the next one and have it delivered to my attendants. When he hands me Robin's head, I'll hand him his own.
That's what I like about you. You have a marvelous sense of fair play.
Now for our surprise guest. Send her in. Thank you for waiting, Prioress.
What is this about, Lord Sheriff?
Oh, you know full well what it's about, my dear.
Come, come. You were in the bandits' camp, were you not?
see no reason to deny it. It is God's will I was born Robin Hood's cousin, and no doing of my own.
Cousin, that's an interesting shade of color. If ever there was a threat to your retaining the Priory of Kirkley's, I would say it was blood ties to a murderous outlaw.
Murderous? You know he's not murderous.
No, not when it's a royal force.
Not when it's self-defense.
Oh, please, I did not bring you here to discuss legalities. The situation is plain. You're doling out stolen money given to you by Robin Hood. More than enough to pack you from the Priory and slap you in prison for good. Unless, of course...
Unless what?
You see, Lord Bishop, she's so eager to make good. I knew you had some in you. You're deporting to me Robin Hood's every move. I want to know what these outlaws are up to. Is that... clear?
Yes, it is.
You comply so quickly, I warn you, if you try any sort of trick.
No, my lord. You have not reformed me. The donations from Robin Hood? I keep half the money for myself. You see, I'm not as strong as my cousin, and in these sad times with Serpent King John...
Take care.
...draining the kingdom dry, the only way I could keep the priory was by going through a little thievery of my own. No. You have not reformed me. I was at your level to begin with.
Come Sunday.
That was 17 come Sunday.
Play it again.
God, Mutch, I ate for this.
Where is Mutch?
I haven't seen him for days.
Ah, you know Mutch. His drawbridge only goes halfway.
At least he's got a drawbridge.
I'd need one too if I had a moat like yours.
Why would you need a moat? Your walls are so low anyway.
What are you two talking about?
Castles.
Robin, two things. First, there's a man approaching from the north headed right for us.
One man?
Aye, never seen him before.
Right camp, Robin?
No, let's see who he is. What's the other thing I've missed?
My turn on watch is over. Can I get something to eat?
Keep playing, Alan. Everyone else, be merry.
To peep at her, then, just to watch the dear little lungs at play, and to see them work as well. A cheery good evening to you all, good sirs and lasses. Well, bless me, I never expected to find lasses in a den of robbers of thieves. Tell me, which one of you is Robin Hood.
Robert who?
No, he said Robin Hood, you know?
Oh, yes. He's the famous outlaw, isn't he? I've heard some smashing things about him.
I'm afraid you have us mistaken, good sir. I am Friar Tuck, and this is my flock. We were just having a midnight mass.
And I, in Philip of France, come to eat British soil from a bowl. Is King John about?
He's a jolly fellow. You're a jolly fellow, ain't you?
Yes, well, we might as well tell the truth now. It's plain you're on to us.
Yes, sir.
We're not here for the midnight mass. We're a band of traveling gypsies. Play, Alan!
What the luck? I'm a gypsy too!
You're a very strange gypsy, aren't you?
Ah, Much was right. Dear Much, he told me you liked a good jest.
Much who?
Much what?
How much? I mean, who is this Much person anyways?
All right, gentlefolk. Play, play your game. I understand. I'll not crack your parapets.
That's really.
I know how risky it is being an outlaw. In all of Herefordshire, there are none as feared as Guy of Gisborne.
Oh, yes. Rob from the rich so we can rob from the poor.
No. Pure fantasy, sir. Rumors and mythological interpretations. When you get famous, the mouths of the countryside feel they have their way with you. Saddens me. Sometimes it does. Good brother Robin gleans the good news, whilst poor Guy Gisborne suffers the bad. Maybe if I were prettier.
That's so sad.
Yes, well, we never turn away a good man, Gisborne. Come, sup with us and stay the night.
You are kind and good, sir.
Tell me, what means that hide you're wearing?
This is the hide of a horse. Its power is passed to me.
Interesting. Little John's got the head of an ox. We don't know what passes through him.
I assure you, good people, the power of the horse is nothing to joke about.
Tell me, Guy, where is this Much? Where is this Much person anyway?
Oh, wandering here, there, everywhere. You know him, Robin.
Hear it, don't you?
Well, I wouldn't mind hearing something at least.
Well, I don't know if I necessarily want to tell you.
Why not?
Well, for one thing, the sole purpose seemed to be to assuage your massive ego.
Well, I think it's rather your ego that's at stake, don't you? When someone can't do a simple thing like admit they made a harsh, irrational judgment on another human being.
How can you say that? Especially after everything that's happened. I should think that after last night...
Hang on. Don't try and buy off my feelings like that.
What does that mean? What are you talking about?
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? I'm just trying to separate work and pleasure. I know you respect me in one area. It's the other I'm worried about.
So you mean that I respect your pleasure, but I don't respect your work?
Well, it sounds foolish now, of course.
I'm glad that we agree.
But you know full well what I mean.
No, I don't, Robin. I don't separate a person from what they do. In this life, you're as good as your actions. And I wouldn't have, you know, if I didn't think, well of you.
Well, that was well put. You left out more words than you put in.
You know what? I was wrong about you, Robin. I was wrong about you, Robin Hood. Steals from the rich so he can give to the poor. Children will look up, the sheriff will look down, but you will always look straight and true. Long live your name, and may all of your offspring be giants. Have I left anything out? Is that what you wanted to hear?
Yes, I think that rather does it.
You're such a Saxon.
What do you mean, Saxon?
Oh, Robin.
Ha 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 ha!
gentlefolk, it seems I made the first terrible wandering woodsman. Never come upon a lad and his lass, unless, of course, the lads are around.
Well, what can we do for you, guy?
Oh, nothing, really. I'm just an early riser. You know how it is when you sleep in a camp you don't know. Someone else's camp. I don't know what it is, somebody else's grass, somebody else's rocks. Yeah, it just makes you restless, I suppose. I'll probably just hunt for breakfast. That sounds like a hearty, robust idea. Hunt for breakfast. Man needs to kill. Fresh scent of blood and meat, doesn't he, Robin?
Well, I never said my name is Robin, friend. You did.
Well, what is your name?
Well, I never did say.
Never did say? Why, that's a fair bonny lass you got, lad. I swear, she looks highborn. Is she highborn?
Lowborn, born in a pond.
In a pond? And I thought you were a fairy princess. Never knew a real fairy princess. What I want to know is, how hard is Robin's head? Will it crack like an acorn? Or walnut?
Save yourself, Aaron, run!
Why so secretive?
Well, if I'm so secretive, don't you think I have a reason for it?
Well, yes. We just thought it might not be a good one.
All right. It's my cousin. The bishop and sheriff found out what she's been doing. They know we're related. They're threatening her with prison if she doesn't comply with their wishes. Poor thing's frightened to death. She sent me a message to meet her here at Tanner's Grove. I'm the only person she trusts right now. That's why I had to come alone.
What do we do now?
You're going back. That's what you're going to do.
Oh, now wait a minute, Robin.
She'll panic if she sees more than just me. Now off with you, the both of you.
You've heard him, Will. He's got to do it alone. You know how he's always right.
Yes, annoying, isn't it? Cyrus, over here.
Robin, I'm so glad you came.
You have nothing to fear. I'll protect you. The sheriff won't harm you. I give you my word.
Yes, Robin, I do fear you are right. You will protect me. I'm sorry, Robin. Survival has never been an easy thing. Like I told you, difficult times.
Now, Prioress, let's not dampen an otherwise triumphant occasion with maudlin sentiment and half-hearted excuses. You betrayed him, and he will die. There, you see how simple that is?
I have done what I have done. Listening to you was never part of the bargain.
Careful, Prioress, I could still change my mind. Ah, the merry bandit of Sherwood we finally meet. I hope it's a greater pleasure for you as it is for me.
Only if you run yourself through a couple times with that sword, my lord sheriff.
Ugh! So bold, the outlaw, so arrogant. That will change.
Don't worry, Robin! Help is fast approaching!
Norman swine, prepare to meet thy doom! Jackals and pomegranates! Deceptive deceivers of deception! Such trickery! Such rude manners! Such vertigo! How do you call mom for you, a littered little hobo? You pathetic little tramp! You have challenged the finest swordsman in the kingdom! Poor choice for a practice bout! I won't need practice where I'm going! You should say that to me! I won't need practice to slice you up! You lump of talking cheese! You loosely strung vegetable puppet!
Will, run off, it's no good!
He who fights and runs away won't get a chance like this again! Bravely spoken!
Oh, I think I'm dying. A glorious end, too. Too bad Robin didn't see.
If only he was quick with his sword as he was with his tongue, perhaps I'd have a match on my hand.
You'll regret what you have done this day.
Until that most fearful time. Take her away.
Shining down upon them like a great, smiling sun from a very high place. The lonely come from miles around to kneel down at his feet, or as close as they're allowed to get, and give thanks just to be alive in his realm. Thank you, they say. Thank you for being our king.
Are you sure this was a mystery play and not a farce?
Oh, mother, you do just well. Why, absolutely nothing will blight the rays of this smiling sun today.
Nothing? Let's try, shall we?
Whatever do you mean, my dearest giver of life? I trust this has nothing to do with your persuasion of the barons. We had an agreement there, an understanding.
Some clouds just passed in front of this smiling sun, or is this a total eclipse?
What could you be saying? Something changed that I should know about.
A smiling sun that sees all? I could hardly imagine. I would have thought news traveled to you faster than a fleet of fishwives.
Pray, what news?
A
Maid Marian Harper has been arrested for complicity with Robin Hood. They are to be executed on the sheriff's wedding day, if you can believe that.
No.
Yes. Your light is dimming, a luminous one.
It's just a mistake. Just a mistake, I assure you.
Then I suggest His Highness correct it.
Yes, I will. I'll go there at once, rest assured.
Oh, I don't think I will. I think I'll go with you.
Oh, yes, quite. I'm sure the sheriff will be honored.
He'll squirm in his breeches and you know it. I'd rather enjoy that. Come, let's away. Tell me, what do you wear to a combination wedding and execution?
I don't know, really. I don't think I've ever...
I suppose black will do.
Yes, I suppose that would be fine.
Or red. For blood.
Yes, that sounds nice.
Working. It just isn't working. I don't even know if a barony is worth putting up with the likes of you. I assumed a simple rustic farm girl would present few problems. Simple. Ha! Nothing pleases you. Nothing placates you. You are stupid, stubborn, and pig-headed. I wonder if I had not done this Allen a Dale a favor. The mere thought of doing anything for the advance of Sherwood caused me utter loathing at the very thought. I have a mind to give you back. That show. But I won't. I'll break you yet, if I have to use sterner measures.
What is it that you want of me?
I did want your love, your respect. But I'll settle for your obedience. You'll soon learn you've seen the Lord High Sheriff in his grandest of moods. Are you prepared for the worst?
I'm marrying you, aren't I? I have no other choice. What more must I do?
For starters, you can smile to anyone, everyone, a warm, friendly, polite, unpretentious smile. Especially to King John.
You can smile at him. Blow him a kiss if you'd like, but I don't feel like it. That's all you really care about, isn't it? Your royal acceptance. A farm girl, a commoner that you've made decent to parade before the court like a puppet. A simple, wholesome baroness for the newly appointed baron. Well, your title and your gold and your power only make me dirty. Do what you want to me. I'll never smile at Black Prince John.
If I promise not to hunt down Allen a Dale and hang him by his neck, will you then smile for King John, my dear?
Royal Majesty, King John.
I'm sorry to break up this tender romantic interlude.
How dare you? How dare you keep Queen Eleanor's favorite lady in waiting, Marian Harper, against her will? How could I have done such a thing?
I don't know. Perhaps you've taken leave of your senses.
Perhaps I have.
I should have your jaw.
I wish you did.
Dare you to hold a prisoner once his obvious a case of mistaken identity is ne'er I've seen. Even the court fool could see that.
Apparently he has.
I demand you release her at once. Do you hear me?
Very well.
I demand it.
Very well, my royal liege. I shall have this poor wretch delivered at once. However could I have done such a thing? 1,000 pardons to both your majesties and any other majesties I might have discomfited by this outrageous and unforgivable behavior. I only wish I may live 1,000 years so I may repay this debt 10,000 times over, provided you live so long as to collect it.
Yes, thank you, Sheriff. That will do.
Thank you both. A sad yet happy ending to a touching and beautiful play. Now that we've left, where is she?
I will have Marian Harper released at once. Hilton.
Yes, my lord.
Have Marin Harper released into royal custody.
Oh, hi. This way, Your Majesty.
Ain't that a bit thick, didn't you? Not that I'm a critic of these sort of things.
Just once do you think you could shine your torch of knowledge in my direction so we don't tread each other's toes in the darkness of my ignorance.
Now you're being melodramatic.
I'm being melodramatic? What about, how dare you, how dare you, for the benefit of the Queen?
The Queen and I have an agreement concerning Maid Marian.
But did you think to tell me?
No, it didn't concern you.
As it turned out, it did.
Do you want your bride to be taller than you at the wedding? Good. Now I'm just dying to meet this Robin Hood, and I want you to be in your usual high spirits.
Have Robin Hood brought in!
Don't you think an execution on your wedding day is just a trifle morbid? Oh well, it's your happy occasion, not mine. Tell me, how is he as a prisoner?
How is he as a prisoner? We have tea at 4, and after that a game of chess. How should I know as he's a prisoner? I'm not the bloody jailer.
You could be. You know what I mean, Lord Sheriff. Have you broken his spirit?
I shall. He's just a man.
He's a commoner. Commoners lead hard lives. They're so used to this treatment that it's become every day to them. I fear they may be building up an immunity. Maybe turning them into supermen.
Robin Hood, my lord.
He doesn't look much like a bandit chief.
No, he's the chief of rats, my lord. Only they don't pay him much. I was just about to give him his daily lashing, my lord.
That honor will have to wait till later.
Later? You can't just rearrange my schedule like that. He'll throw off my entire day.
That's right, pathetic little fool. Make it harder on yourself. This, my annoying little pest, is King John.
This, my annoying little pest, is King John? How does your majesty allow me a servant to talk to him like that? Had a good breakfast, Dickie.
If that tongue were removed, it wouldn't be so quick.
Maybe you'd be able to keep up with him then. Ha!
Well said, my lord.
I grow tired of this carnival atmosphere. Does your majesty wish for any more of this entertainment? Or shall we send in for the jugglers and have the great hall turned into a circus?
I'll turn it into a stable and tinker shop if I so choose.
By all means, bring in the horses and the tinkers.
I'd keep this Robin Hood around if I were you. He keeps you on your toes.
Well, I've earned him a barony. Why not?
Ow! Oh, look what he's doing, putting the two of us against each other.
What utter nonsense!
Why, he's making a fool of your majesty.
You're the one who's falling to pieces.
I am?!
Yes, look at you, raising your voice like that, turning red as a beet.
So are you! So are you! Ah!
You are a clever fellow, aren't you? You know, maybe I was wrong. Perhaps it is a good idea to have an execution on the wedding day. I think I'll rather enjoy it.
Thank you.
When you think about it, need we be so gloomy?
Ellen's to marry the sheriff tomorrow.
Aye, but we'll find a way around that.
Watch this day.
Aye, but we must press on.
Willow's dead.
Aye, that's true.
Robin and Marion are to be executed tomorrow.
I know, but...
And King John will ruin all of England in his war against France.
Aye. Well, when you put it that way...
Marion! However did you escape, dear lady?
I know some people.
Oh, I agree, that usually helps.
Too bad all Robin knows is a bunch of ragged, uncouth old men and hobgoblins running around in the forest.
I'm including myself, of course.
Of course.
We must hurry if we're to save Robin and Ellen.
Aye, we must.
What do we do?
You load of oats. It's simple, mind you. We come up with a plan.
Aye, that's it, a plan. What's the plan?
I'm waiting. I don't exactly hear the twang of bowstrings, because if no one shoots, I've got a couple arrows in my quiver.
What is she talking about?
I think she means she's got an idea. Although, why she couldn't have said that.
We'd be greatly grateful if you did. You see, Robin was always good at that sort of thing, making up plans and stuff.
Gladly, Tom. Luckily, I've learned the layout of the sheriff's castle, and I think we can rescue Robin right under the sheriff's very nose.
And Ellen?
That will be the second step.
The Lord High Sheriff. That's the way.
Look at those healthy appetites.
They would have fought for you. Now they'll die for you.
I'll never understand your logic.
I fear that may be so.
May it be that you go too far in this. Or do my very eyes deceive me? Common soldiers like ruffians eating at the same table as I? Men of ill manner. Quite like savage beasts, so... I swear, one of them rubbed his shoulder against mine. A bishop! Don't you have a trough or something? Some sort of wallow? Perhaps I should join the pigs. I think they're more refined than the foresters. Why, they don't even know I'm holy.
Who, the pigs?
Not the pigs,
my lord. Right now we have far more important matters to discuss than table manners. The queen... procuring the support of the barons, and very soon we shall embark on a great adventure, and I'm going to need both of you behind me.
Oh, I'm not going to war, am I? I don't travel well, and I fare very poorly in battle. We have priests who do that sort of thing.
Quiet, you ninny. He's not talking about that. Monetary support, am I right, Your Majesty?
Exactly. My Lord Baron.
I'm absolutely famished. Join me for a bite, my dear?
I think not. Perhaps later I'll be of stronger appetite.
Of course.
Where are your 3 monks? Why are they not here yet?
They'll be here. They're nauseatingly dependable. I can think of no other reason to have monks at a social gathering except to perform a ceremony. Have you ever feasted with them? Very dull fellows. Absolutely no sense of humor.
Why, you are looking quite fine then, Marion. A far cry from the woods of Sherwood, isn't it? There's really little one can appreciate about the hard life.
Yes,
Luxurious surroundings are a comfort I couldn't go without for long.
Thus, you return to the castles, despite the fact that you are in love with my cousin.
In love? Dear Prioress, a mere trifle. But what would you know of such things? I made good use of this outlaw, just as you did.
Shouldn't we have the bride brought in? Is her father here to present her?
No.
No?
No.
Why not, might I ask?
Don't you understand?
He's not giving her away. I'm taking her. I'm taking her.
Well, who's going to present her then? Well, someone must present her.
Didn't I tell you? You are. Now go fetch her.
I love weddings, don't you?
Terribly romantic.
We present three holy brothers of the Abbey of the Family.
Yes, yes, bid them approach.
This way, please.
Bless you.
My bride will be along shortly. Would someone tell the forcers to quit eating, please? Now, which of you will perform the ceremony?
I'm he, my lord, and these are my retainers.
Very well. Well, why don't you prepare or something?
Prepare, my lord?
Yes, something holy. Don't you have a book?
A book? I need no book. I memorized this ceremony years ago.
Yes, about 100, I'll wager. Where's my bride?
We're coming. You'll ruin the splendor if you keep yelling.
Why, she looks marvelous. Like a deer caught in the torchlight.
This is the bride.
Hey, but she's well jeweled. But this dress makes her look whiter than a moat.
That's my Lord Bishop.
Where did the abbot find you? In a catacomb?
This is my bride.
Oh my, it is. Out of my way. Why is she so sad? I do perceive lilies in her cheeks rather than blushing roses.
Is he a monk or a florist?
Is this a bonny bride? Is this a
bonny bride? Quiet, you doddering fool! Perform the ceremony!
She's not a bonny bride at all. No.
This fellow had some ceremony before he came here.
Does this girl truly wish to marry my lord sheriff? Come on, tell the truth now.
Hold that insolent tongue or I'll slice you in two.
What if I don't want to hold your tongue? Do you really want to marry this greasy toad?
As a matter of fact, no, your grace.
Oh, well then, I pronounce you unmarried.
You say yes or I'll cut you up in an instant.
Why don't you try me, Lord Sheriff?
Robin Hood!
Right again! Oh,
meant to come down to this. The best with the best.
You flatter yourself, my lord.
Already I sense a better opponent than Will Gamwell.
But let's have a man who was that beat him.
Perhaps he was out of his league.
You mean by your league? He'd be grateful for that.
Get up.
King John.
Well, what's it gonna be? A double beheading or a double drawn quarter? That would make eighths, and that would make how many parts?
You wouldn't dare.
Don't dare him! That's all they need! A challenge!
Mother dear, talk some sense into them, won't you?
You're right, John, I should. Strong quarter is really much too intense. Why don't you just behead them?
That's talking sense? Don't ask her for any more help, please!
Robin Hood, I grant you full pardon. You and all your men.
Well, what do you say to that?
Yeah. Then we can live like others.
No more outlaws?
No one to keep the eyes on the likes of them.
No one to balance the books or keep their eye on the poor.
Well, that doesn't sound too good at all. Your Majesty, I just don't think we're worthy of pardons.
Wait, see here, there must be some agreement we can make.
Cut taxes by 3/4.
Oh, never.
Never!
Be absurd.
Oh, be absurd, be absurd. Oh, for God's sake, be absurd!
All right, 3/4 it is.
Up, too late.
Oh, good Lord! Oh, good Lord!
Oh. I'm still alive! Oh, I'm still alive! Oh, that must mean my head is still alive. I'm just a head. Oh, I heard of this happening. Oh, like a chicken. Oh, the embarrassment.
Yeah, Fern.
Your head's like two.
Hereford, shut up. We're not dead.
No. But we're just heads. Living heads. Oh, gambling on. Talking in the dirt for all eternity. It's our punishment.
Sheriff is right. You are a ninny.
Yes, well, 3/4 it is then. Tuck, show him the place to sign.
I'll make sure that my goodly, stout-hearted son keeps his word.
Much thanks, Your Majesty. And since we're so hungry and thirsty after all that fighting, I suggest we make good use of Nottingham Castle for a little while.
Yeah! What a lovely couple. Mother, if I paid for the wedding, would you still let me invade France?
Thank you.
And we have Jesse Gerlach and Kyle Letsem and Miss Walker come to the stage. Come on!
So thank you so much, and thank you guys.
Thank you.
We love you. All right. Yay. Have a good night.